The last general elections will be remembered for its delayed ballot counting that fueled all sorts of speculation and rumors. In the case of one constituency, Babalu, the incumbent Ezekiel Joseph was first declared the winner and then later the loser by a mere 2 votes to the Labour Party's Alvina Reynolds. In the case of Grozely, the final count took days to complete, a nerve-wracking process for the two front runners, with the Labour Party's Emma Hippolyte eventually being declared the winner by 7 votes. Former Prime Minister and leader of the United Workers Party, Stevenson King, says he's disappointed with the electoral process and believes there should be an investigation.
Probably not the commission itself, but the electoral office, the department itself, in terms of its readiness, in terms of its work. There were too many reports of persons not finding their names on the list, the inability of the department to be able to handle this properly. And so down the road, there is need for a kind of review of the operations of the electoral office, the electoral department.
Mr. King says too many people's names were not on the voters' list, something for which he feels the electoral department has to be blamed.
In a number of cases, we have evidence of persons who had turned 18 after the statutory date, who were allowed to vote at the last minute, and that should not have been. There is a cutoff point at which time individuals who turn 18 are allowed to vote. And therefore, one needs to look at that and to see what really guided the electoral department.
Mr. King says it's not about whether people manipulated the system, but about a transparent system in which citizens can put their confidence. For Mr. King, the United Workers Party election loss is a bump in the road as the party looks forward to restructuring in the coming weeks. For the DBS News World, Jason Hollenseed reporting.